Hey guys, a very warm welcome to Arihant Online Academy. In this video lecture, we will learn about the basics of RDMS. Here we will explore the code rules. Basically 12 rules are there. These are the guidelines to learn the RDMS. Without these guidelines, you will not be able to consider that how DBMS works, what query required, what must be a DBMS look like, right? So these are very basic rules which is given by R.J.Codd, also called as code data model, and these are very important because the complete DBMS, you can say that it is a stepping stone for the DBMS chapter, because these rules we must know that what our database structure or database table follows, right? So we can access the data and we can learn the subject, right? So let's start. It is developed by R.J.Codd, also called as CoddRules data model, and it is the most leading data model in real time, right? So real time, if we are using, then we are using these rules. CoddRules basically proposed 12 rules for RDMS development, right? So let's see. CoddRules. So data must be stored in tabular format, right? So in our previous lecture where we have discussed that what is the need of DBMS and each and everything about the DBMS in very detail, that why we are studying DBMS, what is the need of DBMS in computer science, and each and every aspect of that. Further, if you have missed that chapter, you can also go back to our video playlist of the DBMS and you can watch the lecture there, right? Now here, data must be stored in a tabular format. So the very first rule of RDMS or code rule says that data must be stored in a tabular format, right? So table should be there, and in the table format data must be stored, like serial number, student name, age, email, mobile number. Suppose you are holding bank account data, then a serial number, bank account holder's name, his account number, loan amount or total amount, like that. Likewise that a table format should be there. And no two records in the database table should be same. Suppose here serial number 1, here 1, student name here and here same, age should be same, email should be same, mobile number should be same. Means completely it should not be similar, right? Means every record of the table should be unique, right? No two records of the database should be same. It is the rule. Now the second rule, we can say that if a system provides data access to low level records, means if your system is providing data access to low level records, then there must be seen that security and integrity constraint must not be able to subvert the system or bypass the security and integrity constraint. Means if your system is providing data access to very low level records, then it must keep the rule, or it must keep the fact that the security and integrity constraint must not be able to subvert the system, because if it will subvert the system, then your complete system will be less secured, or you can say that your data loss chances should be there, right? So it should be keep in practice. The next is every single data can be accessible with some logical rule. This rule is called as guaranteed accessible rule. Means if you have data in your table, then by any kind of method you are using, table name or row name or your field type, you can access the data by applying some logical rules. It is guaranteed that every single kind of data you can accessible from that format, right? So it is the third rule of code. The fourth rule is null value must be given a uniform importance. Null value should be given uniform importance. So very important factor here, null value, because it might be mean that data is missing. If data is missing, null. Data is not known also mean as null, or data is not applicable, it is also means as a null. So every null should be given uniform importance. Unique importance should be there, a uniform importance should be there, so that the user, or there should not be any kind of ambiguity between the table or the in the field type of the table, right? That what does that null means, right? So it should be given uniform importance. It is the fourth rule of code. The next rule is the structure description of the entire database. The structure description of the entire database must be stored in an online catalog known as data dictionary. So the structure of description of the entire database, right, must be stored in online catalog known as data dictionary, so that from some authorized user can access that and they can directly use the code for that, right? So it should be known as data dictionary, right? So it must be stored in online catalog known as data dictionary. The next rule is a database is only be accessed using a language having linear syntax that supports data definition, data manipulation and transaction management operations, right? So database only be accessed using language having linear syntax that can support data definition, data manipulation and transaction management, right? If your database is not supporting that, then it is violating the rule, right? So your data must be supported data definition, data manipulation and transaction management operations. The next rule is view updation rule. All the updates in database which can be theoretically updated must also be updated by the system. All the updates in the database which we can update as a theoretically points must be applied by the system also, so that they can also update the system or the details or the data in real time also, right? So they must also be updated by system. It is also one of the rule. The next rule is a database must support high level of insertion, deletion and updation. Means your data must not be just limited to only one row or two row, right? It must be support very high level of insertion, support 1000 lines of code, 1000 lines of table is there. So in any row, in any column, if you want to insert, delete or update, your database must support that high level kind of insertion, deletion or updation rule. Or end, as well as with this, database must support intersection and minus operations like that, so that whenever we need any kind of updation requirement in data or we want to modify our data, we can do that with the help of this kind of queries. So our database must support high level of insertion should be there, right? The next is physical data independence. Means the data must be independent of the application that access the database, because there are many applications over which the database is accessed by the application, third party software you can say that. So data must be independent of the applications which is accessing our database. The next is logical data independence. Independent on user's use, right? So logical data independence is it should be independent on its user's view, that how user see the data. User is limited to see only the data that we want to see him, and it should be independent of user's view. You can say that data application or third party software is also able to see only the information that we want to see them. Integrity independence is there. A database must be independent of the application that uses it. Database makes independent from front end interface, like. So it is integrity independent. The database must have its integrity independent from the third party interfaces or softwares. The next is foundation of distributed database, or you can say the distributed database rule. User should not feel that the accessing data are executed or distributed at the different location on the server. Whenever he or she want to access the data, he or she must feel that the data is located at one place in a server and he or she is accessing that, right? So distributed database should be there. So this is the 12th rule of the code. So I hope these rules will help you in understanding what kind of database management is required. These are some guidelines that code gives. And in our next lecture, guys, we will learn about the important DBMS terms in very details, like keys, cardinality, domains, R3, relational schema, relational instance, and keys, candidate key, foreign key, prime attributes like that. So it will help you in getting database from very scratch, right? So beginners can get advantage of that, as well as you can also learn the basics of DBMS, and then we will flow out with our syllabus of DBMS, and each and every topic of DBMS we will discuss there, right? So if you have any kind of doubts or queries, you can comment us. We will try to solve your doubts and query as early as possible. You can also join us on our social web pages, where we are currently updating you with the latest job notifications, current affairs and related topics, so that you can't miss any of the important updates from our side. Now, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon button, so that whenever we will upload new lectures for you, you will get instant updation from our side. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.